यस स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट्स नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सिल्क वॉर्म्स. ओके, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट मैनी एनिमल्स, वी गेट डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स फ्रॉम मैनी एनिमल्स. सो सिल्क वॉर्म्स आर ऑल्सो गिविंग अस अ वैल्यूएबल आइटम विच यू नो दैट सिल्क विच इज अ कॉस्टली फाइबर. ओके, सो क्लोथ ऑफ सिल्क आर वेरी कॉस्टली एंड these are because of its shiny structure or shiny appearance, people like to wear silk cloth. So let's read this. These tiny worms do great wonders. They provide you with silk which is used for cloths and furnishing. As you know that children, silk is a thread, or we can say silk is a fiber which we get from the silkworms. So these worms are doing great job or great wonder. Okay, how they make the silk fiber we will study here. So the rearing of silkworms for the production of raw silk is known as sericulture. Rearing means to culture or to keep these silkworms in their farms. That process is called rearing, taking care of them, provide proper food to them, or provide suitable conditions to those silkworms so that they can grow properly and complete their life cycle. Okay, so that process is called rearing, and rearing of silkworm is called sericulture. Okay, what we called sericulture. And there are several commercial species of silkworms. Commercial means for business purpose, people used to rear many different species. Species means variety of silkworms. Variety of silkworms people used to rear so that they can get different kind of silk from silkworms. Okay, so from these stages of the silkworm, we can understand then how we can get silk. So let's study about this life cycle, how the silkworm it makes silk fibers. So this is, children, these are the silk moth, or we can say silk worms also. Okay, and this adult silk moth, male and female, when they join with each other, then they able to produce eggs. Okay, after mating process, the female moth lays many tiny eggs, and where they lay eggs, they lay eggs on the mulberry trees. It is a means a leaves of mulberry trees. Silkworm live on a special kind of tree or leaves of special kind of tree which is called mulberry. Okay, here they have given name of mulberry. Mulberry leaves, it is a kind of tree, and on this mulberry leaves, when female lay eggs, a tiny black caterpillar hatches out of its egg. Now you see, from this egg, means from each egg, a small caterpillar can come out from the egg. Okay, and after that, what will happen? Next stage means this stage is called larva also. Okay, this is a larva of silk moth. The caterpillar eats mulberry leaves and grows bigger and bigger. It goes through four molds means four stages. When this caterpillar comes out from this egg, it feeds continuously on mulberry trees or leaves of mulberry trees and eats so much of food, and then it changes from this larva to this next stage. Means it undergoes four stages of its life. This is the caterpillar. So see how it converts into first into this form, then after this, means it grows bigger and bigger. Okay, how it grows bigger and bigger? Because it consumes so much of food material, and then it grows into a size, and after attaining a bigger size, it make a covering around it also. Okay, and inside it lives sufficiently and properly. It can live inside this case. Okay, so after this, the caterpillar spins a cocoon of silk threads around itself. Now you see, when caterpillar is like this, that time it start releasing a thread like structures around it, and it wrapped around around itself a thread like structures, which are the threads of, or we can say fibers of silk. Okay, and in this stage, when it wrapped silk fibers around it, that time we call it as a cocoon. Okay, and see inside this cocoon or fibrous structure how the caterpillar, or we can say pupa, here in this stage, this stage is called pupa, and this pupa stays inside the cocoon. Okay, and now third stage is this pupa. First is egg, second stage is larva, which is previously this in this form, black in color, and after that it changes into white in this way, and third stage is pupa stage. Now pupa stage, along with the cocoon, means its covering, this is the main stage which we use to get silk. Okay, the threads, or we can say the fibers, which is formed by this pupa around it, these are the valuable fibers which we get by boiling these cocoon in hot water. Okay, and during boiling process, this pupa can be killed inside it, and we get these long we can say shiny fibers from this pupa stage. Okay, and after that, children, those who are rearing these silkworm, they always not collect all the pupa stage, or always not collecting all the cocoons, because if they collect all the cocoons, then how the next generation can be continue? So they leave some of the cocoons to complete their life cycle, to make more silk moth. Okay, so those cocoon which are not collected by the people or which are rearing them, those pupa stage again converted into a adult. Okay, from pupa stage again it will convert into a adult stage. So here they have written, the pupa changes into a moth, the moth comes out of the cocoon. Means they, when it changes into an adult, then it automatically breaks up this cocoon part, and this kind of adult can come out from this cocoon. So children, in this way silkworm complete its life cycle, and side by side it provide us a valuable fiber विच वी यूज टू मेक क्लॉथ्स और विच वी यूज टू मेक एक्सपेंसिव क्लॉथ्स वी कैन से. दीज एक्सपेंसिव क्लॉथ्स इंक्लूड्स सूट मटेरियल, साड़ी और दीज मैनी अदर वैल्यूएबल थिंग्स ऑल्सो विच वी कैन मेक फ्रॉम सिल्क. ओके सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द सिल्क वॉर्म्स.